Three women say their Airbnb stay in Rialto, California, just east of Los Angeles, came to a scary and really bad end when they were swarmed by police. Maybe you've seen this Facebook post that's gone viral now. These young women describe checking out of their short-term rental when a squad of police cars show up, the neighborhood seemingly locked down. Police say an elderly white woman in the neighborhood called 911 thinking that these women were burglars. Well, one of them is a filmmaker. The other is the late Bob Marley's granddaughter. They recorded what was happening to them.
There's like three black people stealing stuff.
Stealing stuff?
Yeah. Like breaking into the house and taking
things. No, we're taking our suitcases out of the house.
Right. They said like luggage and stuff.
Because there's three black people in the neighborhood, of course.
It's possible, but like I said, you never know.
It's not possible. It's not possible. That's what's happening.
Rialto police have issued a statement saying they, quote, conducted a reasonable inquiry, adding that the women were never put in restraints and that they were released without incident. Airbnb has also issued a statement saying what happened was, quote, unconscionable and a reminder of how far we still have to go as a society. The women, they say they plan to sue the police department, but the owner of that Airbnb tells CBS News that race had nothing to do with this. She says the neighbor who called the police didn't know about her Airbnb rental and was concerned because of some property crime recently in the area. Okay, let me talk about this with Joey Jackson. Brother Jackson, I'm so glad you're here to talk to me about this.
Good
to have you with me. This is a frustrating thing. You know, I had a girlfriend say to me, like, what is going on? Is this happening more now? I don't know about you, but I feel like this is happening the same as it always has. This is probably nothing new, but what is new is that people are feeling more emboldened to record what's happening to them in the moment because of social media and the availability to be able to broadcast those things to the world.
And thank goodness for that, right?
Yes.
Because it takes us right there to the place of what occurred, and it gives you a sense of what was transpiring. So let's just back up to what you were talking about. Race had nothing to do with it, and, you know, we just had some run-ins recently in the neighborhood, and it's an Airbnb.
What do you say to that?
What I say is this. Let's evaluate it on its face. If it's an Airbnb, I would imagine that it would be transient. There would be a number of people who were entering
and
exiting,
sure.
Right? And because that's what Airbnbs are. So what I would want to know is how many times did this person call the police on the other transients who were coming out of that B&B, right? So how many times? And what was the basis, if any, for what you were doing that for? So it seems to me that to suggest or say that race has nothing to do with it, you're being disingenuous, and that's not fair to having a conversation that we need to have as to how this could possibly happen. You're carrying luggage out of a residence, right? So now you have driving while black and walking while black. Now it's carrying luggage while black, right? So the fact is, how do you now say that that constitutes a burglary? That's my one issue that becomes problematic to me at the outset. Now you skip to the police where you have a helicopter and seven police cars.
Joey Jackson.
Right? So why? What is up with that proportion of a response in this situation? Does a response like this, does it appear that you need that in order to address this situation? And so just addressing the elephant in the room, Michaela, you have to ask the question. If they were not African-American women, would you need helicopters and seven police cars and put your hands up? And so it becomes a problem. And to say race has nothing to do with it doesn't
it's
give credence to a conversation we need to have, which is why is this happening over and over and over again?
Is there, so we know that the women plan to sue, so we know that there's going to be civil action there. But beyond that, is there any merit? There's merit, obviously, because they were, their civil rights were abused here, were they not?
So, you know, and yeah, let's examine that. And so, you know, a lawsuit is one thing, and laws provide remedy for civil rights. And to those wondering, well, what is that remedy? The remedy is, you know, you have a right not to be interfered with, impeded upon, or stopped, or encountered for not engaging in any criminality. Last I checked, carrying luggage does not constitute a crime, nor probable cause to believe that a crime had occurred. And so the police now, when they're evaluating the issue, have to exercise some discretion in doing that. And so I think the case will turn on the nature of the interaction, the length of the interaction, the discourse that occurred during the interaction, what happened in the interaction, and I just think reasonable minds have to prevail.
Here's my question. Okay, so take off the lawyer hat and just talk to me as my pal Joey for a second. You know, Philadelphia Starbucks, the Nordstrom Rack that we saw back east, the kids shopping for prom. This story here. We can, I don't know that we can legislate this stuff. We can sue our way out of this. How do we change this? How do we we can't just tell people stop calling police when you feel afraid of black people, because it goes deeper than that. I mean, that's what they should be doing, but what I mean, how do we get to the bottom of this, Joey?
It really does, and it's a wonderful question, Michaela, because taking the law to the side, how you feel, how I feel
as
a human being, it's a difficult scenario, right? And so when did we become a society that was just so afraid of people who look different, who wants to get rid of anyone who's an immigrant, who says, okay, they're African-American, the police need to be called, and when they're encountered, we don't believe you. We never heard about Airbnb. Produce your identification. What are you talking about? Who's the landlord here? I mean, there has to be some discretion involved, and so you need a police officer or police in general that are reflective of the community, that understand community. You certainly need to put neighbors on notice that you may have Airbnbs or whatever that's going on, but we got to talk about it, Michaela, and that's why it concerns me when people are like, race, come on, race, really? She just didn't recognize
that's
the
upsetting.
People who were there.
That's upsetting. So, you and I have both had our own issues of being followed around stores, of being eyed suspiciously when we've walked in to establishments. We know what it feels like, and until you felt that, you
not
don't.
Not a great feeling.
It is a terrible feeling.
Right.
Joey Jackson, I love when I get to talk to you as a legal mind and as a human mind. Thank
Thanks
you.
Thanks for having the conversation,
friend.
Michaela, because that's where it starts.
We got to talk about it.
Amen.
Just because it's uncomfortable, we got to talk about it.